When Apple came out with watchOS 10, they introduced a new feature, widgets. What we're able to do is add little snippets of information from specific apps, much like we do on the iPhone, the iPad, or even the Mac. Now, when they introduced this, there wasn't much fanfare for it, and understandably so, there weren't a lot of apps that used these widgets. Basically, we had the Apple widgets. I created a video on it. It's pretty cool, but we couldn't really see the full potential. Well, now, several months later, I can see the full potential for these widgets. Now, let's first take a look at where we access these widgets. What we need to do is we just need to swipe up from the bottom here, or what we can do is we can use the digital crown. So I swipe up from the bottom, I'm looking at my widgets. Now, right now, I just have the standard Apple widgets here. We have the calendar, weather, news, and then my activity. I tap on any one of these to open up the app, just like we do on our iPhone, iPad, or Mac. Now, why am I excited about this? I just created a video on this just a few short months ago. Why am I recreating it? Well, what I've realized is the full potential of these widgets. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back over to my Apple Watch. But before we do, what I did is I went and added some of my favorite widgets. So then you can kind of see how I use these and how it opens up the door for me to use other watch faces. Then what we'll do is we'll go back over to my Apple Watch with just the standard widgets, Apple Watch widgets, and I'll show you how you can add widgets and organize them. So let's go and see how I use this with my favorite widgets. Let's go back over to my Apple Watch. All right, the first thing is I can use watch faces that don't have any complications on them. So this is Snoopy's watch face. It came out with watchOS 10. If we look, it does not have any complications on it. All I need to do is just swipe up, and what you're going to see is I can check my trips, upcoming trips, and what I'm able to do is check the battery of my car, and if I want to warm up my car, I just tap on the climate control, and it's warming up my car. And again, I can do this from a watch face that doesn't have any complications. So now I'm able to use all those other watch faces. In the past, I had to use watch faces that had complications. I no longer have to do that. Also, what it does do, as you saw, is it makes it really easy to just go and warm up my car or check the status of a trip. I don't have to open up an app. I don't have to go and look for that specific feature. It just shows on that widget. So that's why I'm really excited about this. All right, let's go and take a look at how we can create these widgets or add these widgets to our watch face. So what I'm going to do is remove all these third-party watch faces, what I'm going to do is remove all of these third-party widgets, and then we're going to take a look at how we can add them back into our Apple Watch and how we can organize them, pin them, and even change them as well as remove them. So let's go back over to my Apple Watch. So what I'm going to do is swipe up. First thing I want to do is I want to add Tripsy. Tripsy is an app that I use that helps me monitor my trips. So what I need to do is I need to long press on this, and then we tap on the plus because we're going to add another widget. And then from here, I just swipe up until I find Tripsy. So what you want to do is you want to see if any of the apps you use are listed in here. So when I swipe up, you're going to see that I have Tripsy here. So I just tap on it, and there's the widget that I can add. This is the only widget that this app has, but it gives me what I need, so I'm okay with that. So I just tap on it, and now I've just added that widget. So when I tap on done here, what you're going to see is I swipe up, and there's my upcoming trips. So I no longer need to have a complication for Tripsy. I can just swipe up or use the digital crown to view that information. If I want to pin it, maybe I want to have it up towards the top, I can do that as well. We can reorganize these. So now what I do is I long press on it, and then what I need to do is tap on the pin here. When I tap on the pin, what it'll do is it'll move it up towards the top or one of the first widgets. So now when I tap on done, there it is. Let's go and add a couple of widgets from Tessie, which is how I control my car. So again, I long press on it, tap on the plus, and then I swipe up until I find that app, Tessie. And what I want to do is add a widget to where I can see the battery level. So now I just tap on this to add it in there. And there it is. I also want to add another widget that warms up the car. I live in Michigan. It's a little bit cold, so I need to precondition the car before I go anywhere. So I tap on the plus. I go over to Tessie. And then you're going to see when I go all the way down towards the bottom, we have one that is called climate. So I just tap on climate and I've added that widget. I want to pin these. So again, tap on the pin here. And that one is pinned. I tap on the pin here. And now that one is pinned. So now what I would like to do is warm up my car. I'm going to meet my brother for some pizza and a couple of beers. So I need to warm up the car. So I swipe up. All I have to do is just tap on this. And what it'll do is it'll warm up my car. I want to check the battery level. I just swipe up. I can check the battery level. Let's go and change one of these widgets. We can do that as well. So now all I have to do is long press on it again. And if that app has multiple widgets, remember, Tessie has a number of different widgets. All I have to do is just tap on it, and then I can switch it to a different widget within that same app. So what we're able to do is change the widgets. And then if I want to remove it, what I need to do is unpin it. So I'd first need to unpin this, and then once I unpin it, I can go and remove it. I don't want to remove this, so I'm just going to tap on done. I actually do need that in my Apple Watch there. And then if I wanted to add Spark Mail, I could do that as well. Just long press on it, tap on the plus, and then I could add a widget for any incoming mail. So that is another look at widgets and how I use them. I have actually found out that they are more powerful than I originally anticipated for a couple of reasons. First, it gives me easy access to it. I don't have to open up the app. Even when we use complications, I still had to open up the app and then go and find that feature. Well, now with these widgets, I have a widget just for warming up the car. I have a widget just for looking at my upcoming trips. So that is really handy. On top of that, what I'm able to do is choose a more simple watch face, maybe a more fun watch face. Some of the more fun watch faces do not have a lot of complications. So I'm able to choose one of those watch faces, and I don't have to worry about the complications because all I have to do is just swipe up to access my widgets. So that's widgets. What I would recommend you do is take another look at these widgets. Maybe the apps that you use also have widgets. Just swipe up, long press, and if your app is listed in that list, when you tap on it, you're going to be able to see all of the widgets that are available. Maybe there's going to be a widget that will allow you to have a little bit more flexibility in watch faces like what I do. So that is another look at widgets with watchOS 10.